vocalist for Ballyhoo Foxtrot Orchestra and Soya Vista Jazz Combo. She's been entertaining in Des Moines for 30 years in the Des Moines area, and I guess you started when you were about 6, probably. The John Morgan Orchestra has been a swinging band since the late 1980s, and they feature a Hoover High School graduate, if not more than one, a high school classmate of mine, so it's always fun to see your friends. The orchestra has been swinging big bands since the late 1980s, and they feature some of the finest jazz musicians in Des Moines, so you are really in for a treat. Let's welcome to the stage the John Morgan Orchestra and Gina Gedler.
Everyone knew the names of everyone in the band. The sidemen were as big of a star and as well known as the frontmen. Of course, we're talking about the big band era. Tonight's Jazz in July show will show the gradual move from instrumental stars to vocal stars. Instead of one particular female giant of jazz, Gina's going to schizophrenically sing the great styles of many women. Here is another instrumental, before we bring Gina up, that never needed a singer to sell it.
So this could be an interesting night. Did he just say I was schizophrenic?
It's a matter of speech, isn't it?
I don't know. I think it might be partially true.
Alrighty. In 1944, Les Brown and his band of renown, with Doris Day as vocalist, had a hit record with the song Gina's Gonna Sing. It was Doris Day's first number one hit in 1945. The song's release coincided with the end of World War II in Europe, and became the unofficial homecoming theme for many veterans. Yes, here's Sentimental Journey, but since it's jazz in July, I'm very proud to present this arrangement. It's a very old one in our library by Des Moines' own Jazz Hall of Fame legend, Don East. Here's Don's arrangement and Gina and Sentimental Journey. We'll start it out and she'll take us home. Thank you.
had a little journey to renew old memory. Got my beds and got my reservation. Spent each time I could afford, like a child in wild anticipation.
I still gotta do nice and innocent, don't I?
Oh, Gina.
Oh.
Wonderful job. In 1944, the same year, Kitty Callan, as with Doris Day, became a household name after styling the song It's Been a Long, Long Time with the Harry James Band. The next song Gina will sing, I'm Beginning to See the Light, was written in part by both Duke Ellington and Harry James. But it was the James version that was the immediate hit, outselling all other versions. I found that interesting because I'm a great Duke fan. Oddly, many singers credit Pretty Kitty Callan as a blues and early jazz influence, but her career was sporadic at best, and only the Harry James tunes were her number one hits. Yet this woman, Kitty Callan, helped make it a jazz standard. I'm Beginning to See the Light.
Your lips are burning mine.
like Kitty. That was it.
We're going to bring Gina back in just a bit. So what do the instrumentalists do as these vocalists rightfully start to take over? They have to work harder. And so the instrumentalists had to come up with instrumental hits that were instantly as identifiable. Night Train is next. The song has a complicated history, but it ranks as one of the most endearing instrumental hits without a vocal star. The original riff was from a Johnny Hodges riff on an Ellington tune called Here's the Blues Man. And it kind of went like this. And that was Ellington and Johnny Hodges. But when Jimmy left the band, a young saxophonist named Jimmy Forrest later left that band and scored an R&B hit of all things, calling it Night Train. So here's Night Train, which is a version of a Les Elgar cover and our own twist.
Thank you.
How about that? That's what they had to do to keep up with the singers. The next song, in 1941, going to rewind just a little bit, is ranked number 6 of all time of the last century. It's the 6th best song of the entire last century. The tight harmonies of the Andrews Sisters and the runaway popularity of the song make it one of the pivotal pieces that did start the move away from big band superstardom to vocal superstardom. Of course, it's the Boogie Woogie Bugle Boy. Here's some fun facts. The song was actually introduced in an Abbott and Costello movie, and there are still trumpet players and their descendants arguing that they are the original Bugle Boy from Company B. Well, here's Gina and our own Bugle Boy, Jim Bovinette, to do a jam version of the great Boogie Woogie Bugle Boy.
He was a famous trumpet man from that Chicago way. He had a boogie style that no one else could play. He was the top man at his craft. But then his number came up when he was gone with his draft. He said, the company of Hello, Rivoli. He's a boogie woogie bugle bar, Company B. They made a blow bugle for his Uncle Sam. He really brought it down because he could not jam. The captain seemed to understand. And so the next day the cap went out and drafted a band. And now the company just when he was ready. The bar, his boogie rhythm, can't go numb, that's the basic guitar playing with him. And the company jumps when he was rambling, he's the boogie woogie bugle boy, come on in me. He was the boogie woogie bugle boy, come on in me.
Agenda. And her star first flashed as a band singer with Benny Goodman. But this next song is as vocally trend-setting for its subject matter as the arrangement is to big band jazz. Gina now sings "Why Don't You Do Right" like some other men do.
Okay, I gotta get my Peggy Lee on now.
As vocalists started to continue to trump big bands, instrumentalists had to work harder to compete. So they turned to the exciting sounds of Latin dance music, and it began to work. The next song is one of the 20 most recorded songs of all time. It's hard to believe that it wasn't even popular until Mickey Mouse made it famous in a short Disney cartoon called Saludos Amigos. But Xavier Cugat did the rest. Here is Brazil. A Don Hoy arrangement, and Mark Grimm on drums will show us all how to samba. Going to dance, we won't stop yet. It's 1952 now, and Rosemary Clooney has risen to superstardom. All of these women had an indelible mark in both jazz and popular music. So she mixed jazz phrasing with Latin music, and her career as a vocal superstar took off. Here is that classic arrangement, Angina, with Sway.
Away.
I'll get enough jam. Whoop whoop! Whoop whoop! Instrumental crowd countered with South Rampart Street Parade the very same year and the Richard Maltby Las Vegas arrangement. Before we take a short break, here comes Ray Vedute's famous South Rampart Street.
Don't go anywhere, we'll be back in less than 10 minutes.
Hey, Jacob.